In this video, I will talk about the operation of an astable multivibrator. The multivibrator are the electronic circuit that produces non-sinusoidal waveforms, especially square, rectangular and sawtooth waveform. Now, I will talk about astable multivibrator. The astable multivibrator will also be a multivibrator circuit, and this astable multivibrator will generate square waveform without using any external triggering pulse. The astable multivibrator is also known as free running multivibrator. You have to be careful about this word. This astable multivibrator will generate square waveform, and we don't have to apply any external triggering pulse. If I consider the external triggering pulse as input, then in the input side we don't have to apply any external triggering pulse in the astable multivibrator, and in the output of this astable multivibrator we will get a square waveform like this. This square waveform will have two level, zero level and plus VCC level. Let's say 41 time interval it will be at zero level, and 42 time interval it will be at plus VCC level. If I want to represent this 0 and VCC with binary value, if this represents logic 0, this plus VCC will represent logic 1. Therefore, I will get 0, 1, after that 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. If I analyze the output waveform of an astable multivibrator, we will get a square waveform. Let's say for T1 time interval it will be at plus VCC, and for T2 time interval it will be at 0. This will represent logic 1, this will represent logic 0. 1, 0, so this will be 1, this will be 0, and this will be 1. The word astable. This A means not. That means the output of this multivibrator will not stable. An astable multivibrator has no stable states. That means for a brief interval of time our output will be at 1, after that it will come to 0 and remain at 0 for a time interval of T2. After that there will be an automatic transition from 0 to 1, and it will remain at 1 for T1 time interval. After that there will be automatic transition from 1 to 0, and this process occurs continuously in an astable multivibrator, as the output of this multivibrator is not stable either at 1 or in 0 level. It is known as astable multivibrator. This is called free running multivibrator because for the transition from 1 to 0 or 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, 0 to 1. That means for the transition between the levels we don't have to apply any external voltage. That's why this is called free running multivibrator circuit. The operation of a multivibrator circuit will be totally dependent upon the switching property of a bipolar junction transistor. When the bipolar junction transistor acts as a switch, it will have two states, on state and off state. A bipolar junction transistor is said to be in on state if I supply a positive voltage of plus VCC at the collector terminal when the input voltage VI is less than 0.7 volt. This transistor will be in off state. When the transistor is in off state, the collector and emitter terminal gets disconnected from the circuit. Therefore, this transistor will act as a open switch. Therefore, the collector current IC will be equal to 0. As the collector current becomes 0, the voltage difference between the collector and emitter terminal VCE will be equal to plus VCC. So when the transistor is in off state, I can summarize it, our collector and emitter terminal will get opened and the collector current IC will be equal to 0, and the collector to emitter voltage VCE will be equal to plus VCC. Now if I apply an input voltage base to emitter voltage VI greater than 0.7 volt, our transistor will be in on state or in saturation mode. When the transistor is in on state, the collector and emitter terminal will get shorted. As the collector and emitter terminal gets shorted, therefore the voltage between the collector and emitter terminal will be equal to 0 volt. because we are taking the output volt, we are taking this VCE across a short circuit, and the current that is flowing through the collector terminal will be IC set, saturation current. So I can summarize this property: when the transistor is in on state, our collector and emitter terminal will get shorted, and I collector current will be equal to IC set, and VCE collector to emitter voltage will be equal to 0 volt. This is the circuit diagram of our Astable multivibrator circuit. Here we are using two identical transistor Q1 and Q2. The transistor Q1 and Q2, although they are identical, but they have different doping profile, which I will show you in the later segment of this video. The transistor Q1 has collector load RL1 and the transistor Q2 has load resistor RL2. The transistor Q1 is biased through resistor R1 and the transistor Q2 is biased through resistor R2. See, the collector of Q2 is connected to the base of the transistor Q1 through the capacitor C1, and the collector of Q1 is connected to the base of Q2 through this capacitor C2. And see, this structure is symmetrical to this structure. So I can conclude that an Astable multivibrator consists of two identical common emitter configuration. I can take the output from this terminal to ground, this collector to ground, or from this collector to ground. Let's say I am considering this VC2 as our output. I will supply this entire circuit with this voltage source VCC. The plus terminal is connected here and the negative terminal is connected to the ground. I will supply plus VCC by closing the switch S. After closing the switch S, both Q1 and Q2 will try to drive in on state, but one of them will be on state at a time, therefore other will be in off state. Let's say at first this transistor Q1 is in on state. So when the transistor Q1 is in on state, that means the collector and emitter terminal of the transistor Q1 will get shorted, therefore the voltage from this point to this point, VC1, will be equal to 0 volt, and the transistor Q2 will be in off state. As the transistor Q2 is in off state, that means the collector and emitter terminal will get disconnected from our network. As the transistor Q2 is in off state, the collector current IC2 will be equal to 0. Therefore, the voltage drop in this resistor RL2 will be equal to IC2 RL2 will be equal to 0. That means plus VCC that is applied from this point to this point will be appeared across the collector to ground terminal or the emitter terminal of transistor Q2. That means for T1 time interval, this voltage will stay at plus VCC or logic 1, and this voltage will stay at 0. So when this transistor is in off state, the capacitor C2 will get charged through this way. Until this ground, as the charging current will flow in this direction, that means this terminal will be positive and this terminal will be negative. This capacitor stores a charge Q2, therefore it will have a voltage of VC2 across it. Now see, the positive terminal of this capacitor is connected to the base of the transistor Q2, and the negative terminal is connected with the emitter of this Q2. That means plus VC2 is directly applied between the base and emitter terminal of the transistor Q2. As the capacitor continuously charging, therefore when the voltage across the capacitor is greater than 0.7 volt, that will drive this transistor Q2 in on state. So when the transistor is in on state, that means the collector and emitter terminal of this transistor will get shorted, therefore this VC2 will be equal to 0 volt. So when this collector to emitter voltage reduces to zero. This voltage will be applied from this terminal to this terminal. That means it will be applied between the base and emitter terminal of the transistor Q2. Therefore, see, this is equal to 0 volt. As the base to emitter terminal voltage is equal to 0 volt, our this transistor will now conduct in off state. As this transistor is in off state, that means the collector and emitter terminal will get disconnected from our original circuit. Therefore, the collector current here IC1, will be equal to 0. Therefore, the voltage drop IC1 RL1 will be equal to 0 volt. Therefore, our output voltage now will be equal to plus VCC. Now see, when this transistor is in off state, the capacitor C1 will get charged through this way until this ground. The charging current will enter from this direction. So this terminal will be positive, this terminal will be negative. Let's say this capacitor is charging and stores a voltage of VC1. When this VC1 will be greater than 0.7 volt, that VC1 will see the positive terminal of this VC1 is connected with the base of the transistor Q1, and the negative terminal, this is negative terminal, this is a short circuit, so this negative terminal is connected with the emitter. So when this VC1 is greater than 0.7 volt, it will trigger this transistor in on state. That means this terminal will be, the collector and emitter terminal will get shorted again. Therefore, its voltage will come at a level of 0 volt, as the voltage between this point to this point is reduced to 0 volt. That means this transistor will be in again off state. So when this transistor is in off state, its voltage, there will be a transition in the VC2 from 0 to plus VCC, and this transition from 0 to plus VCC or plus VCC to 0 will occur automatically in this Astable Multivibrator, and this is how it will generate a square waveform, and we don't have to apply any external triggering pulse, and therefore this is known as free running multivibrator circuit. And if I show the output of this multivibrator, if I consider the output voltage as VC2, I will see that it will be at plus VCC level for a time interval of T1, or in logic 1 for T1 time interval. After that, it will come to 0 level and stays at 0 level for time interval T2. After that, it will again come to logic 1 and stay there for time interval T1, and it will again come to logic 0 and stay at that level for time T2. Thus, it will produce a square wave, and we don't have to apply any external triggering pulse for this operation. Therefore, this is known as free running multivibrator circuit. And see here, the period of this square waveform T will be equal to T1 plus T2. Okay, that's it. While discussing the operation of a multivibrator circuit, I have told you that no two identical transistors have the same doping characteristics. To show that, I have set two BC547 NPN transistor here. Let's say this is our BJT1 and this is our BJT2. We can understand the difference in doping profile by measuring the built-in potential of this transistor 1 and this transistor 2. Both of them are BC547. See, in case of this transistor 1, the base to emitter junction voltage is equal to 0.612 volt, whereas our transistor 2 base to emitter voltage junction voltage or built-in potential has 0.611 volt. This indicates that although they are from same family, they don't have similar doping profile. If I measure the collector to base voltage, because if this is an NPN transistor, it will have two PN junction. One is from base to emitter and another is from base to collector. Here our transistor 1 has shown collector to base junction voltage 0.60 8 volt, whereas our transistor 2 is showing collector 2 base junction voltage 0.607 volt. This indicates that although they are from same family, they don't have identical doping profile, therefore they will not act similarly when we supply a bias voltage in a multivibrator circuit, and one of them will try to trigger on ahead of other. Okay, that's it. Thank you.